Hi everyone, my name is Hemali Vadalia and I studied computer engineering from this very college, Somaiya College, in 2006. So back then, like any other engineering student, I wasn't sure what I really wanted to do in life, you know. But I was sure of one thing. Coming from a traditional Gujarati family, I always wanted to get married before I turned 25. Dalai Lama says, sometimes not getting what you want is a wonderful stroke of luck. That was true in my case. Now, almost 10 years later, today, I have been pursuing an artful life. I have been traveling, studying, and collaborating with artists and studios all over. And recently, I was part of a film that was nominated for the Oscars 2018. So... So I'm here to share my story. I was introduced to art at an early age by my mother. She used to make these beautiful rangolis during Diwali throughout the night. And I would sit there and watch her. Later even I started making rangolis. But then life happened. I got really good marks in 10th and 12th. And I decided to pursue like engineering. I studied computer engineering. And I scored well in engineering and I got a good job in an IT company. But while working at this IT company, I realized that, you know, this is not something I want to do for the rest of my life. And that was like, you know, marriageable age for a traditional Gujarati girl. And it was easier to get married if you're not working. So I quit my job and I dabbled with the family business. And that is where I realized that, you know, I could do much better in life if I worked on something I cared about, you know, something that I was good at. So I didn't see myself staying there for too long. I wanted to change something, but I didn't know what. I thought marriage is a good thing, you know, it'll change my life. But it didn't work out. A friend told me that, why don't you pursue higher studies? I wasn't sure it would delay the marriage. But anyway, I applied for this master's program at Industrial Design Center, IIT Bombay, to study animation and film design. And I got through. Everyone at home was like really surprised, but it was an easier shocker for them because it was IIT Bombay. Then in IIT Bombay, I was like, this is it, you know, up to life set here. I'll have a great education and an amazing creative career. I'll be very good at drawing, painting, animation, filmmaking, and I'll do well. But it wasn't like that because there were so many things to be learned that I couldn't really excel in one field. But this education gave me a very good start into this field, and I'm thankful for that. As a student, I made two short films in stop motion animation. My drawing skills were not very strong then, so you know, I tried like working with tangible mediums to create things. I did clay animation there, and my engineering background helped me to be more open to experimentation. You know, I was like mixing different techniques to make my films look good. So we'll see some of the shots here. So I would make these puppets, I will shoot my friend's eyes, and then I would paste it on top of the characters that I made. So after IIT, I couldn't find a job that I really liked. And I wanted to work with traditional mediums. You know, I like working with tangible mediums. So I decided to do freelance. And it was all going very well. I was working with, you know, people all over. And it was really nice, like, in the beginning. But after a point, it all got very repetitive. You know, I felt like I was stuck with the same kind of work. And I wasn't really growing. I felt that I must study the basics of art, fundamentals of art, to grow, you know, in my career. And I found out about the ateliers in Italy, in Florence, that teach the techniques of old masters. And when I looked at the works, it was so amazing. I really wanted to go there and study. But I didn't have the courage to tell my family then. But then something happened. I lost a dear cousin of mine, who I was very close to. And when things like that happen, you really get numb. You start questioning everything in life. And there is a void that cannot be filled. You can't really move on without changing something. I realized how unpredictable life is. And I didn't want to plan too much for the future, you know. Like, I didn't want to wait for someone to come into my life and change it. I wanted to change it myself. And all the dreams I had, I wanted to live them. So I applied to these ateliers in Italy, and I got through. It was like a huge step in my journey because it was the first time I left home to go abroad and study. It was, you know, I took some time in convincing my family, but they all agreed at the end. Then I went to Florence, and it was like a different world. It was like a very new world for me. You're surrounded by art everywhere, and it's like very artful life there, right? And first time I realized that to make a beautiful painting, there is so much science that goes into it. Like, you have to understand human anatomy, skeletal system, muscle structure, its movements. Because if you don't know it exists, then you cannot really draw it. Like, if you are making a portrait, and if instructor tells you to work on temporal muscle, so you should know where it is to be able to, you know, develop that area in your drawing, to be able to draw it well, right? So little things like this, if you focus on them, it really lifts your work. Also, there is this physics, you know, principles of light and how eyes see color. While chemistry is involved in preparation of pigments, which oil to use so that it will slow down yellowing and cracking of paints in your painting. Also, like, mathematics helps you understand perspective very well, so you can make beautiful architectural studies. So I understood that, you know, art is not just emotions, it's also a lot of science. And back here, like, we feel that, you know, art is not a real education, but when I was there, I felt it was pretty intense and a very structured education in itself. And I also thought that, you know, if I have to take it as a career, I need to have a lot of patience with myself. And I can connect this with my roots back home, putting rangoli. I want to show you a picture of rangoli that I made in 2006. And it took me a lot of time and patience to improve my work. I realized that results cannot be achieved just in a couple of years. You know, you really have to work hard. So this is the rangoli I made in 2017 of Dalai Lama. It took me about 45 hours over a period of 3 days. And all this while pursuing art, I also kept creating artworks in clay and paper craft. A lot of them were selected for International Plastics and Art Show and Paper Art Show in Israel. So I made these works in 2013, and they were selected in 2017. So this shows, like, you have to have, like, a lot of patience, you know. When you create something, it'll find its place, but it takes time. So, and this traveling alone, I got to live with the families, and that was, like, the best part of it, you know. This very cultural, like, it was a very enriching experience for me. And traveling alone also helped me learn things that I couldn't learn in a protective environment of my family and friends. Situations, good and bad, give me the courage to try something I had never tried. So, like, anyway, like, from Italy, when I got back home after 10 months, I, like, getting married was always on the back of my mind, and it was emotionally very draining. But Dalai Lama says that a situation cannot be bad from all aspects. Had I been married, I wouldn't have pursued art so sincerely. And it gave me time and mental space to think about what I really wanted to do. I wanted to study art in more depth, and I also didn't want to settle for anything mediocre. So I applied to one of the most prestigious ateliers, which was in New York, and I was accepted. New York education taught me how to see. I was surrounded by such beautiful art made by the students and instructors. It was unlike any other experiences I've had, and I felt I belonged there. I wanted to learn more, and for the first time, I felt art can be a good career choice as well. I want to share one painting that I really like. It's by Jules Bastien Lepage. He's a French artist, and this portrays a daily mundane life of potato gatherers, celebrating hardships with all its dignity. And it inspires me so much to recognize events from my own daily life and to make art out of it. We live in a world that is, like, really fast-paced and so much glamorized that we often tend to, you know, overlook these simple things that bring so much joy to life. Art for me is, like, it is very therapeutic. and it helps me connect with the deepest emotions that I feel. When I was visiting the museums to see old masters' work, I came across this painting, and amidst all the chaos around me, there was this silent moment between me and the painting, and it was so powerful that I had tears in my eyes, and I felt that I was there for a reason. After New York, when I had to go back home, I was restless. You know, I wanted to go back and study more, but situations didn't allow me. I was figuring out, you know, what to do, and I was clueless. But then I learned that Loving Vincent filmmakers were looking for artists to finish the film. It was the first fully hand-painted animation feature-length film, which is nominated for the Oscars now. But back then, like, I applied with my portfolio, and I could see the connection. Like, you know, I could combine my interest in painting and animation for this project, so I was like really excited. I applied with my portfolio and I got selected, so I was really happy. It was like a dream. It was the biggest project I had worked on, and it was in the city of Poland, this beautiful little city, Gdańsk. It's the most beautiful cities I ever lived in. We'll take a look at a small clip from the film.
Like it's my business.
No, my job is to bash metal into shape, not deliver leathers.
So this little clip that you saw is the result of so this little clip that you saw is the result of 101 paintings. It is one of my shots that were included in the film. We used to work on 12 frames per second. So to create 1 minute of animation, you need to have 720 frames or 720 paintings. The entire film is made up of 65,000 frames. I was there for about 6 months, and I created like 367 frames that became 7 shots in this beautiful film. The entire movie was first shot with real people, like real actors, as a live action film. And then the videos of this live action were then used to make the paintings. Every artist had painting and animation workstation, which is like a box with control light, camera, projector, and a painting board. So you make a painting and take a picture with the camera. You scrape it off to make the next painting or next frame, take a picture, and repeat the process. So when you run all the frames or paintings together, it appears to move. It was like the first time this kind of technique was used. And apart from that, like, we were 125 artists. We have 125 artists on this project, and I was part of the Gdańsk unit. There were 3 studios, 2 in Poland and 1 in Greece, Gdańsk, Wrocław, and Greece. So I was in the Gdańsk unit. Our daily commute to the studio was through the sides of the forest, so you would pick apples and cherries along the way, and it was very beautiful. Like, it was very different from how I've lived in Mumbai, and I fell in love with it. Yeah, and there were artists from all over. So we were all, like, although we were all very different, it felt like, you know, at the core, all the human emotions are the same. Had I not taken any chances in my life to pursue my interests, I wouldn't have been a part of this beautiful project. And I wouldn't have met all the lovely people I met in my journey. Following your dreams and passion is always very fulfilling. A little encouragement and support at the right time can often change everything. My journey from beginning as a software engineer to this point has been very adventurous and rewarding, with its highs and lows. But I've learned to be true to myself. I feel that you don't have to have everything figured out in life. A lot of good things develop slowly. Like, I've recently been offered a scholarship to study academic art at the same atelier in New York. And I feel that it is okay to be uncomfortable and not very confident when you take your first step. It is okay to try out things when people around you do not understand. It is okay to not lay down a complete path, because vision evolves over time. Just listen to your inner voice, because it already knows what you want. Thank you.